Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Skyrim. Where we sort of seem to have lost our vampire follower. She's sort of buggered off, and now I have to go talk to Isran and tell him what's happened, and hopefully he won't actually be too horribly annoyed with me. I have to be honest, I genuinely don't know where she's gone. I tried to play the surprise off as being in character at the end of the last episode, but no, I literally have no idea what's going on. I've never tried to come back to Fort Dawnguard before at this point in the story. I kind of just did it because I thought maybe there was some extra dialogue, and so I decided I'd come back here, and besides it sort of felt like the sort of sensible in character thing to do. So that's why we're here. I didn't expect Serana to just fucking, do a vanishing act. I don't know whether she's meant to do that or whether it's a glitch. Let's hope it's on purpose and not a glitch. I have played Dawnguard before you ask. I have played it before. I've done it a couple of times, but like I said, I never actually decided to do this specifically last time I played it, and to be fair, it was a long time ago when I did last play Dawnguard, so I'm a little rusty, if you like. A little unclear on the details. But anyway. Got a massive cup of coffee with me at the moment, really, and half of it, I swear to God, is just so I've got something to warm my hands with, because it's so goddamn cold in here right now. Find myself making hot cups of tea and coffee at the minute, literally just so I can hold a hot mug for a while. Hold a hot mug. Make of that sentence what you will. But anyway, yeah, it's fucking freezing, that's all I'll say. So, coffee. Anyway. Are you two coming as well, or are you. Right, okay, thank you. You're gonna be the other two schoolboys, shuffling along behind me while I get the brunt of the telling off, aren't you? I'm also hungry and thirsty. I think we might stay here tonight, actually, as well. I don't know where Serana's buggered off to, but she can probably take care of herself. So yeah, I think we'll probably stay. I mean, not that this is a particularly homey place, but it's got walls and a ceiling, so it'll do. Better than my bloody tent on a mountainside, anyway. Now then, I believe we can find these run up here, I think, somewhere. Oh, charming. Great, a torture chamber. Just. These are fresh! They're covered in. Jesus. Wow! What the fuck was he even up to? Killing vampires is one thing, but. Torture tools, take. Do I want to take the torture tools? I'm not sure I do. Although, sweet mother of Christ, look at that thing. Okay. What's with all the mead? That's sort of the. It seems oddly out of place. Did he just set up a torture chamber here in the larder? I could go for some mead right now, but I don't think I want to drink torture chamber mead. Okay, Isran, we need to have a talk, mate. Because that is disturbing. Fuck disturbing, it's horrifying.
So, any luck? Was Tolan right about the vampires being interested in Dim Hollow Crypt?
Were you awake this whole time? And so when I walked over here, when you were lying down, you were just like, so. You are one creepy motherfucker, and I don't trust you as far as I can throw you. And considering I have unrelenting force, that's pretty far. Tolan was right, and he's dead. Yeah, the vampires killed him.
Damn fool. I told him not to go. The Vigilance always had more bravery than sense. Did you at least find out what the vampires were looking for in there?
Well, he's not wrong, is he? Vision is definitely a more bravery than sense. I speak from personal experience. It seems they were looking for a woman who was sealed in a crypt. Not making this up, by the way.
That doesn't make much sense. Where is this woman? Who is she?
The where part is something I'm wondering too. She didn't want to... Well, evidently, she didn't want to follow me here. But she wants me to take her to her home? I'm pretty sure she's a vampire, actually.
That would fit with the rest of it. I don't like it, but you did right to play along. We need to find out what this is all about. I won't lie. If this were any other situation, I'd put her down just on the chance she might be a vampire. But this is something different. I'd say do what she wants. Take her home. And see who else is in this castle.
Alright then. Fair enough. I was expecting to be told off a bit more than that, but I think we got off lightly. Yeah. I think she might have been wise not to follow me here. I can only imagine what might have happened if she did. Fucking Mr. We have ways of making you talk over there. Good God. Right. Ugh. Anyway, yeah, so, just charming. Gosh, make the blades seem like charming, wonderful people, really. What are we... Oh, hello. This place is truly massive, isn't it? Dead Drop Falls. No, I don't think I want to go there. I'm gonna find a bed. Doggies! Nice dogs. Skillang. And Bran. Alright, hello. Jolly good. We'll carry on. Carry on, doggies. Chest. Ooh! Thank you very much. Yeah, not sure how I feel about the Dawnguard right about now, honestly. I mean, vampires are one thing, but then this is sort of a bit of a stretch in the other direction, if I'm honest. Hello. Agmer, how you doing?
What can I do for you?
Nice outfit. Why did you join the Dawnguard? They seem like a bunch of loonies. More dangerous than mere loonies, frankly, if I'm being honest with you. They're sadistic bastards, really.
I've heard the rumors around Skyrim. I know something's going on, and I've seen the vampires. I felt I had two choices. I could either live in fear of the night, or I could do something to help protect my people.
By, well, okay. Who am I to judge? I haven't had friends and family taken away and had all their blood sucked out and, chowed down on by, well, let's face it, glorified cannibals. So I guess maybe I'm not in a position to judge, truly. But anyway.
Take care.
I'm gonna have a drink. I think I need one. Whew. That's warmed me up. Nice. I got any grub? A gourd, a leek, 3 uncooked mud crab legs. Okay, I don't know why that was difficult to say. A sliced Idar cheese. I think I need something a little more substantial, if I'm being completely honest.
Oh, did you need something?
Oh, hello. You? I did not see sleeping there. I thought you were a pile of food, if I'm being honest with you. That's... Oh dear. I haven't been infected with vampirism, have I? Oh, that's not good. I didn't realize there were beds in here. There's another person here as well. Durak, whoever the... Oh yeah, you're the Grimby Orc. Okay, fair enough.
Oh, did you need something?
I suppose I can sleep in that cot if I want to. I suppose there's anywhere a little comfier. Wow, okay. You lot are about as messy as the companions. At least the companions have a cleaning lady, mind you. Alright, come on, there's gonna be some food here somewhere. Chicken! Okay, chicken, salt. There's any butter lying around. Beef! Alright, you know what, lads? We are gonna have a mighty feast. Rabbit. We'll leave the rabbit. More salt. As if I needed more salt. Rimshot. Anyway. Here we go. Nom, nom, nom. Aha, right. Is there anything... Oh, so maybe we could make a stew, but... Beef stew? What do I need for that? A carrot. Oh, of course. And what did I find in a bag of things only yesterday? A carrot. And I did not pick it up. What a champ. Maybe there's another carrot lying around here somewhere. Come on. I can't be... I'm this close to beef stew. Oh, I love a few of those. Potato... I bet I can use those for something. It is unbelievably dark in here. I... What? Wine? Wine's always good. A barrel containing cabbages. More salt. Apples. Cabbages. Oh, for the love of a carrot. Just salmon. Seriously, do we... Oh, it's a fish barrel. No, thank you. Really? We don't... Come on, there's going to be one carrot in this entire goddamn place. You'd think they'd have a few, you know, for the whole seeing in the dark thing. Carrots! Oh, yes, here we go. I'm going to make so much stew now. I'm just going to see if there's anything else around here worth grabbing. Clam? No. Alright, boys. Stew it is. And more wine. Never enough wine. Yeah, I'm basically robbing the Dawnguard blind, I know. Whatever. We'll call it requisitioning. There you go. Not robbing. It's requisitioning. Beef stew incoming! Lots of fucking beef stew, apparently. Yikes. Okay, and some grilled chicken breasts. Hell yeah, now that's more like it. Nom nom nom. Nom nom nom. Nom, and some grilled chicken breasts. Fuck yes, now that is what I call dinner. Right, I'm going to bed. Oh, you know what, I'm going to warm up a bit here as well while we're at it. Do-do-do-do-do. Where's my hood? I'll take my hood off indoors, it looks silly. There it is. There we go. Nice and toasty. Alright then, well, let's go have a poke around for some sleeping quarters. I have a feeling I might just have to settle for the cot or one of these bales of hay. Now I think about it. That just... that doesn't lead anywhere. I think it goes up to the roof, if I'm not mistaken. Or up there. Good lord, this place is actually quite impressive. Sort of reminds me of the Imperial Palace. I've already said this, haven't I? The architecture looks remarkably similar. Yeah, anyway, alright, well, I'm not sleeping up there in torture chamber land, so I'm gonna grab myself a cot, I suppose. I don't know what you guys are gonna do. I guess you're just gonna have to sleep on the floor or something. So... pardon me, viewers. I'm kind of tired myself, to be honest. Jesus! Christopher! Fucking... Walken. Do not do that. That is creepy as hell. Okay. Yeah. Moving on. I need a drink. And another one, apparently. There we go. What? This? Oh, yes, that's the crossbow. Away with you. I said away. Thank you. Why do I have a feeling the next time I come back in here, the ragdoll physics or whatever it's called are going to go berserk, and that's going to go ping all over the room as soon as I walk back in. You know it's going to happen. Holy HDR lighting, Batman. Look at that. Wow. Okay, now that's gorgeous. I forget how good this game looks with an ENB installed sometimes. He's not that far off Fallout 4. I'm throwing that out there. This game, the way I've got it set up now with all the mods and stuff and the ENB, it's pretty bloody good. I'm impressed. Who the hell are you?
Worthies, Ellen Wins Furious. Big party at the Thalmor Embassy, and one of the guests went someplace they shouldn't. Caused quite a commotion.
Yeah, wouldn't know anything about that. No, sir. Madam, what's behind here?
It's been a long time since I've spent so many hours outside. Yesterday, I think I burned the scales on my nose. It was a peculiar feeling.
It's the first time I've heard you say anything that sounds remotely like a normal person. Where the devil does this go? Mossy Glen I never noticed this before. What on earth? I'm going in here. Mossy Glen oh, crap. I can't see anything. Yeah, I forgot. I need lantern oil, and I couldn't buy any because... Oh, bears. Oh, you know, it's just a cave full of bears. Let's leave them alone. Good heavens. I mean, really. I'll come back here later whenever I can actually see what I'm doing. Right now, we need to go back to Riften and buy some lantern oil. Lots of it. Lots and lots of it. Oh, we've got a little garden. How adorable. Okay, well, anyway. I guess everyone... It explains where all the carrots and cabbages come from, I suppose, are in there. Unless they send someone out shopping every weekend into Riften. Can you imagine? Can you imagine, like, the orc fella just sort of being sent off... Oh, hello. Look who it is! Can you imagine, though, being sent off, like, with the shopping list? Like, off you pop, then. Saturday morning. Off down the shops. You! We meet at last, once again. Oh, you. Right, you know what? I can slow time, you can't. Rest in peace. I don't think I need elk hide for anything, but I do want the venison, and I'll take the fucking silver ring. Another married woodland creature. Mossy Glen. Oh, okay, same cave as back up there. Oh my god, it makes me wonder what other stuff is in Dayspring Canyon, because I've never noticed these caves before. Right, anyway, where's her Royal Highness, anyway? Where are you? Come on. For heaven's sake, where's she gone now? She was there, right? I wasn't just seeing things. I want to get up there. Don't ask me why, I just do. Uh-huh. Elk murder! Oh yeah. That's what I'm here for. Bad luck. Do you remember when I had that Hunterborn mod installed? It was a nice idea, but it really was tedious after a while. There's such a thing as too much realism occasionally. And this presumably is where the Dawn Guard do their fishing. And curiosity almost begs I dive in there and I go have a swim around and see what I can find, but Frostfall has a way of making you absolutely terrified of water. Especially water with ice floating in it. Oh, we'll get over and see. You guys are going to start a fight with me now. I've already got enough mud crab legs, I don't need any more. I'm going to get up there. Pretty sure I can't, though. This is the one. I do not know where Greg is, for that matter. Where's Greg gone? Greg? Echo. Oh, there you are. Go on, slow coach. For heaven's sake, man. Have you eaten one too many pies this morning? You're running a bit slower than the rest of us. Well, you know, who am I to talk? Apparently I've got the Hungry logo again. The Apple of Doom in the bottom right of the screen. I'm just going to ignore it for now. I want to get up there as well. That's something I used to delight in when I was playing games when I was younger, was trying to get to places in games that you weren't really supposed to get to. Just for the sake of it. I mean, oh, hello. Back in the day when you were... Oh, she's returned. Okay. But, you know, back in the day when you had about 3 games to play in an entire year, and you kind of had to get your money's worth. Right, we're not jumping on the horse, because we know what happens when that happens. You gentlemen, on the other hand, though. Yes, you run away.
Walk away, now.
No.
You're interfering with official Thormor business.
What on earth do you think you're wearing?
Walk away, now.
Be Make careful. Me. Come on. Think you're so tough? In your big fucking Fisher Price green pointy armor.
Let's move faster.
What do you think you are, a Power Ranger? Jesus. Look at you. Fucking, you know, when you wonder why no one takes you seriously. Fucking hell. What are you like? You know, I'm gonna let you go because frankly, there is nothing I could possibly do to you that would eclipse the shame you must have from what you must, you know, have from wearing that ridiculous outfit all day. Oh my. Well, at least that way. You know what? You've reached a certain point where even the Thalmor are just, you know, they're not stupid enough to fuck with you, even when you're literally pushing them around. I think they know who I am by now, guys. Anyway. You.
It's so bright out here. I don't know how you stand it.
It's lovely. Shut up.
Shouldn't we keep moving? I really want to get back home.
Are you feeling okay? You're not going to, like, you know, burst into flame or something because we're out in the daylight or something, are you?
It's so good to breathe again.
I suppose we should head to your inverted commas home then.
Let's go.
Great. Okay. Well, alright, fine. I'm still not going to ask if that's an Elder Scroll because I've decided that I don't know what one is. And of course, everyone had an opinion on that, didn't they? Oh, but you would know what an Elder Scroll looks like. Why? Jesus. Why? Why on earth would you look? What? It's not like we live in an age of photographs. It's not like Claudius can go on Google and have a look at, you know, Elder Scroll and have a look at a, you know, a flipping photograph, is it? You can't go on, you know, theimperialcitylibrary.com and, you know, have a look at some pictures. Never seen one in his life before. How on earth is he supposed to know what one looks like? Have you ever seen a drawing of an Elder Scroll in one of the Elder Scrolls games ever before? I don't think you have. Like on a wall as part of a mural or something? Oops, sorry about that, mate. Because I haven't seen anything like that. How am I supposed to know what an Elder Scroll looks like? I don't, is the answer. I haven't got a bloody clue what the Elder Scrolls look like, so, you know. Touch who? Oh, you know what, just... You guys have fun. I don't even know where I'm going in the minute. I sort of don't care. I think there's a cave up there. No, I can't go poke around in a cave, can I? Because I've got to go and get some lantern oil. I don't even know where I am. Like, I think I'm genuinely lost. Which is a sort of a nice feeling, but at the same time, I kind of want to get back to Riften. I need to go that way. And naturally, there's a mountain in the way. Very good. Oh, hello.
Somebody help.
Morning, chaps. Oh, Christ. Oi, prisoner's running away. You guys deal with the bear. You... Don't even think about it. Don't even think about it. Uh-oh. Oh, Christ. No. Okay, that is stupid. That's just genuinely fucking stupid. They would not attack me for shooting the prisoner who was running away. They would, more to the point, I would not get 40 bounty. I'm even part of the fucking Legion, for God's sake. Oh, Skyrim logic. Gotta love it. Okay, oh, we're back here, are we? Very good. You know what? You know what, I don't do this often, but today it's happening. Flippin' ick. That's all I have to say to that. Anyway.
Have you
I guess we're about going back to the
pawn
prawn.
Dragon attack. Kynesgroth this time.
You've already used that line, mate. Is there nothing you ever talk about other than that? Carry on. I guess you must get pretty bored standing around there at that gate all day. You probably run out of things to talk about after a while.
If you're looking for it, you'll want to speak with my husband. If you're looking for company, I suppose I could do that.
Right. Where is that over there? House in the middle of the lake. Whatever. None of my business. What's Honeyside? Okay, that's not the shop.
It's so here.
Welcome, Percy Honeyhand, we meet at last.
I have all sorts of interesting items.
Yeah, I don't care about your interesting items. I want your lantern oil. Where is it? Come on. Pony up the oil. Water barrel assembly pot. Really? No, thank you. What in God's name is that even for? Water barrel assembly parts. It's obviously from a mod. I don't even have a clue what. I need, perhaps? I have no idea. Anyway, never mind. Lantern oil. I will take the lot. Thank you very much. You know, it's funny, really. Like, you got all this stuff, like glass lying around and goat horns and straw. You know, I'm not going to do hearth fire. It's effectively pointless. I've got a much nicer house anyway. I have to admit, there's something kind of vaguely immersive about having you know, just random sort of everyday items like this in the shop lists that, you know, you're never going to buy them, but it's just cool that they're there. It reminds me a bit of Morrowind in that you could sort of just walk into a shop and, like, buy crockery if you really wanted to. You wouldn't. You never would. You would not go around buying blue glass pots unless you were sort of a bit of a loony and you were trying to decorate a house you'd stolen from a dead person, because that's how Morrowind worked. Don't mind me headbutting the fucking blacksmith sign while calling other people loonies, but, you know. But it was cool that it was there, nevertheless, you know?
Yeah, this should help.
It makes the world seem a little bit more real and a little less like a video game, so I approve on the whole. How you doing, Shadra?
Huh? What do you want?
Nothing. I was just saying hello. Do you work at the stables? I presumably must have seen you there.
Yes. Hofgrier took me in when I arrived in Riften about a year ago. He's been teaching me everything he knows. Horses are my whole life. Back in Hammerfell, I helped my family raise horses at our farm. I hope to open my own stables one day, but I think it's going to take a lot longer than I expected.
Why is that? You in trouble or something?
I owe a great deal of money to someone, and I think they cheated me. I don't know what to do.
Oh dear, this is where you have to do the whole hero thing, isn't it? Tell me the details, I'm going to spill the beans, come on, what's going on?
I was able to work out a deal with the stables in Whiterun to sell me some of their tack and harnesses. I borrowed some gold from Sapphire to pay for the shipment, but it got robbed before it even arrived. Now Sapphire wants her money back, and if I don't pay her, I think she's going to kill me.
Could you not do that? Please. Honestly, like, if as if the fiery horse wasn't enough, and you just sort of swanning off whenever you damn well please, the teleporting and walking through walls just is not done! Apologies, Shadra. I was... Anyway, what were you saying? You know what, I'll help you pay off your debt. I'm basically a millionaire anyway, so...
You will? Oh, thank you.
Just work on your lip syncing.
Be careful with Sapphire.
Speak to Sapphire about Shadra's debt. I think I know who he's talking about. It's the grumpy bitch who stands around in here all the time.
If you've got the coin, you've come to the right place. Pull up the seat.
Yeah. What's your problem?
Oh, Christ, it's you.
What is it?
Nothing! Get out of my face!
You're here too, huh?
Right, you. Yeah.
What's your problem?
Where do I begin? I've got lots of problems, but specifically, I'm here to talk to you about Shadra's debt.
I knew that stupid kid would try and find a way to weasel out of his debt. Look, this is really simple. I lent him some gold, he promised to pay me back, and now he says he's broke. End of story.
Should I just pay it off? I can totally afford to, but I don't know, she's just ticked me off. Drop the debt, or answer to me, guy who slays dragons before breakfast, for, you know, a bit of fun. Seriously. I put on the big scary mask and everything, you will be sorry you were ever born, trust me.
Are you kidding me? I've got the entire Thieves Guild at my back. What have you got?
Okay.
You can go back and forth all you want. He just needs to pay.
Yep, very, very good, very good. I'm just gonna, right. So, everybody, I have a feeling this isn't gonna work, but... I have an idea. I have no idea what this is going to do. Nothing, apparently. Well, never mind, then. Well, this is awkward. What on earth is... Oh, F9 is quick load, but my track AR is running, so it doesn't work. I forgot. Whoops. Alright, well, I just will, you know... Where is that? Yeah, Old Faithful. Hello!
Hey.
Oh yeah, I thought this might. Sapphire, dearie. Right, there we go. Failed. Speak to her. Well, yeah. Poor salt, really. Sapphires. How amusing.
These lacos are rare in this part of Skyrim.
What a waste.
Yeah, what a waste of good magic, I suppose. Waste of a good ice bolt. Yeah.
Oh, what happened?
Good. Feign ignorance and you saw nothing. Good man. I like the way you're thinking. Okay.
Welcome to the Bee and Barb, my lord. If I can interest you in one of our special drinks.
See, look, they're all on my side. They're all carrying on as if nothing happened. Thanks, everybody. Right. And you can all thank me later, you know. Well, we'll clear them out. Fucking Thieves Guild. One git at a time. Well, you know, that should have solved the debt problem. I'm curious. I didn't get a bounty for that, did I? I'm reasonably sure I didn't actually get a bounty for that. Halfingar bounty. Halfingar is not here. Yep. No. Doesn't look like I've got. Wow. When on earth did I get a bounty of 10,000 gold? Crikey. That must have been quite the event. I have no idea when that happened. Huh. Anyway. Yeah, alright then, well. If that's just outright failed the quest now, that's kind of dumb. Because I solved the problem. Where's Chardra at? Anyway, where is he? Honestly, if you'll say anything if I talk to him. I'm genuinely curious, because I feel like if this is a proper role-playing game, supposedly, that killing Sapphire should have been an option. A viable option to sort of solve that quest, if you like. We finally established a launching point into Morrowind, just in case. Hey, you leave Morrowind alone. They're nice people. I've been there. They're actually quite charming. Riften Stables, maybe? Chardra, buddy, how you doing?
Horses are all I know. I've been riding since I could walk.
Alright, he's got nothing to say. You know what? I'm going to chalk that up as a success, frankly, because he evidently doesn't have a problem anymore. Business as usual. He's doing his stables thing. And it's sort of a case of wink, wink, nudge, nudge, say no more, say no more. No one's discussing the fact that Sapphire's now dead and we're all fine because of it. I don't even have a bounty. Even the guards look the other way. We're all good. Let's continue. It was a little possibly bloodthirsty of me, but she provoked me, okay, guys. And you all backed me up there, didn't you? As did everyone. I'm not a lunatic, am I? I'm not a psychopath. And she's complaining about what's good for her skin, so you know what? Business as usual. Continuing on. I will try not to make a habit of that, everybody, but she just, you know, it was the Marty McFly moment when, you know, she did the equivalent of calling me chicken. Anyway, I've got lantern oil now. That's nice. So we're going basically to the other end of Skyrim. In fact, yeah, we could not go any further to the other end of Skyrim if we tried. So that's going to be quite a trip. My map is all foggy as usual, but I don't really know what to make of this, to be honest with you, because normally, like a big old journey like that, something I'd sort of rub my hands together and think, ooh, excellent, and look forward to. But the problem is, we've got to sort of travel through a whole bunch of bits that we've already traveled through a shitload before. So it's not actually that interesting a journey at all. It's the equivalent of going down the M1 at this point, you know? We're just commuting at this point, aren't we? We're not exploring or having a grand adventure. We're just sort of taking the train. We can get to work on time. Mark, I really should go back to Markov at some point. Find myself a reason to go back to Markov, because I've barely spent any time there whatsoever. Hang on, have I even been into Markov itself? I'm not 100% sure if I have, you know. I don't think I have. I don't think I've actually been inside Mark Arthur. I've apparently been to the stables, at least, but I don't think I've actually been inside the city. I probably got a carriage there or something, and that's why the stables are revealed. Yeah, I probably did, and that's how I got the Skyhaven Temple, maybe. Wow. Isn't that insane? We got to Chapter 6 of this Let's Play, and I still haven't been to Markarth. That's pretty crazy. Anyway. Right, I was going to jump on my horse then, but then I realised who we're travelling with, so... Right. Let's see. So, let's take stock. We've got four of us in total. We've got Among the Hist, we've got Greg, and we've got Serana. Our entire party at the minute is 110% overkill right now. And I feel like we ought to ditch someone, at least. Greg, I hate to get rid of you, mate, but I'm kind of thinking I might have to send you back to Yorvaska just to sort of make everything a bit of a, you know, give myself a bit of a challenge, because otherwise we're just going to ruffle stomp everything we come across. You know? Where are you lot off to? Out on patrol, I suppose. Yeah. Well, you know what? You can come along for now. You can come along for now. See how we get on. The thing is, I kind of want to go. Well, we need to go get this bloody chamber pot. That much, that's got to happen. That's probably the next thing I will do, actually. But I did want to also go and check out, what's it called? The Lost Temple of Revokheim. But that's sort of, I kind of wanted to do that, if not by myself, but without a sort of small horde of people following me around. Because, it's just a... It's a sort of weirdly personal thing going along and looking at Revokheim. Because it's sort of ever since bumping into Mirak and having to kill him, I've become absolutely fascinated by the whole Dragon Priest's Ancient Nord Dragonborn thing, and it's sort of a personal journey to discover more about who I am and why I'm here and that kind of thing. I don't really want a small crowd of people following me around, you know? So I don't know. I kind of fancy doing the whole Revokheim thing by myself. But you lot are here, and I can't get rid of you, can I? I don't think so. I'm gonna try it now. We'll see what happens.
Oh, what is it? I disagree.
Right. Okay. Good. Fine. I guess that's the end of it. This is why you don't argue with women. I disagree. That pretty much sums up why.
I doubted whether our world, the gods' absolute righteousness, was true. Was but a failure to reconcile with those we labeled as demons.
Oh, really? Are we gonna... This is why I don't travel with people. I'm gonna have a sit down in the spot of lunch. You guys just figure out life. I'll be chowing down on the rest of the stew. What do you think, Kosh? Do you reckon we could get away with just running off while they're all preoccupied with the goddamn elk? We should just leg it out. Never mind, they're back. I might not be able to get rid of you, but I can get rid of you.
Yours is to pass, and ours is to delight.
Alas, forsooth, my dearest friend. It is time for us to parteth of the ways.
I understand. Always walk the true path, and always have the wisdom to recognize it.
Yeah, you, off you pop. Where's he gonna go? Like, are we gonna run into him again? He's a bit of a loony, but I like him for that. I like having an eccentric lizard following me around everywhere. It's kind of fun. spouting off bits of Shakespearean weird dialogue at me. It's, well, see you, buddy. I hope we run into you again, because you're quite amusing. Greg.
What is it, Thane? I will be back at your house if you need me, Thane.
Jolly good. Oh, are you going to head back to, Halfenheim? Or are you going to go back to Yorvaska? Either way, it doesn't really matter. Off you pop. His horse is leaving as well, I think. Excellent. Oh, see you later, Greg. He probably do the break anyway. He's going to go off to the pub, isn't he? Look at him. Off he pops. He's like, finally, I get a day off. Good lord, I'm going to follow this fucking whiny Imperial around all day. Now I'm going to go get pissed and find some wenches. Look at him. Oh, Greg. Anyway, all right, Serana, just you and me now. We are going to go and find an ancient Nordic chamber pot of legend. I am not making that up. I suppose, although last time you were around wondering about Skyrim, it was just a regular chamber pot. So, but anyway, we're going to go find a chamber pot. So, yeah. I don't quite know how or where we're going to get to it, though. No, that's not it. Joran's prize. Skithr Skal, a prized artifact. It's rumored to be held in Nevik's vault, a Dwemer ruin. Oh, this will be fun, won't it? Skithr Skal, ring any bells? No? Alright then. Okay, so I'm gonna go this way. I don't even know where I'm going, but that's sort of the point. I don't care. I just want to wander off and explore for a bit, and we'll wend our weary way up towards Nebik's vault eventually. One way or another. Cave! Right, I'm gonna go explore that cave. You know what? Waste not, what not.
Who's there? I knew I heard
oh,
something.
Good heavens. Oh, it's the Power Rangers. Very good. Really Frostbite Spider. Now is the time of it. This is a coordinated attack. The Frostbite Spiders are allied with the Thalmor. Come on. Killing Thalmor with Elven Arrows. I love it. The irony is delicious. That was awesome, Serana. Do that more often. Ouch. Finish him off, then. Mercy! Yeah, have fun with my vampire friend. She's really good at the whole zappy thing. Better than you, as a matter of fact. Stop playing with your food. Kill him, come on. Get on with it. Rest in pepperoni. Execution order. What are the odds? It's going to be go kill Claudius. Imperial called Claudius. He's an enemy of the Thalmor and has actively disrupted our activities by pushing around our finely dressed Power Rangers. And simply, it must stop. It's just frankly uncouth and it's not on. It's just not cricket. How very dare he? You should go and kill him. I feel like, at this point, I don't think the Thalmor are realistically trying to kill me. What they're actually doing, and this is quite cunning, I will give them that, is what they're doing is they are getting rid of their undesirable officers and soldiers and stuff by sending them on suicide missions to try and kill me. That's what they're doing. That's like that's what Elenwyn's up to. She's just sort of like, she's got these guys she wants to get rid of. And so she's like, right, okay, you've been specially selected for an assassination mission. You're going to go kill Claudius. And she's just sort of sniggering because she knows they're all going to die. And it's perfect because she wants to get rid of them. And they don't really have a choice, so they've got to do it. Fallow Stone Cave. Right, what do you want to do? You want to take bets, Serana, on what's going to be in here? Where are you? Oh, please tell me you haven't disappeared again. Oh, whatever. I'm going with wild animals. When I saw the name Fallowstone Cave, I was thinking maybe Falmer, but no, I think I like wild animals, judging by the bones and everything. Oh, are you cold? Is the poor vampire cold? Wow, I'm pretty cold, actually. My breath's all frosting and everything. Let's get inside. Fallowstone Cave. Alrighty.
I'm okay with the dark, but I've spent more than my share of time in caves all.
Oops, it's not that. Yeah, you and me both, Serana, honestly. Okay, admittedly, I haven't spent like the best part of 1,000 years or so in a cave, but I have been in a few, and I'm trying to remember. Oh, I actually have to equip the lantern in the first place. That would certainly help. Here we go. Come on. Oh, there we go. I had it for a second. There we go. It's a little bit delayed from when you press the button, so it actually lighting up. Well, by jingo, that is quite the sight, isn't it? Holy sweet Mary, mother of all that's... You? Are you... Is that a Minotaur? It's a flipping Minotaur? I'm sorry, I barged into your cave. You'd like me to bugger off, wouldn't you? I'm glad you find it so flipping romantic. There's a bull-headed monstrosity over there that would like us very much to piss off or die, however. Should we try... I'll try and make an effort to stay out of its way. I mean, really, it's... He wants to be left alone, so he's buggered off to a cave in the middle of nowhere, and I can kind of respect that. So let's try not to tick him off too much. It's just he's sort of right there, and I want to get across this bit here. I'm just passing through. This is a very big cave. I think it's a little unfair for you to just claim the entire thing. What the hell? Oh, that's just a bit of rock. It looked like a severed arm. Look, mate. I'm just passing. Let me just. Whoop, 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 whoop. Just toddling on across this bridge here. Yep. Thank you very much. Right, see ya. Ta-da. That is a weird looking Minotaur. He looks a bit malnourished, doesn't he? Honestly. Kind of cool though, actually. I mean, look at him. Is he going to get and react unfavorably to me doing this? But I just want to get a closer look at him. He just looks a bit skinny, doesn't he? But he's sort of... Kind of cool. Kind of a cool bit of design that, actually. He's quite creepy looking. Actually, as opposed to sort of the cartoonish Minotaurs I remember from Oblivion. Fair play, modder, whoever it was who shoved him in here. I think it must be from Immersive Creatures, surely. Either way, well done, because that's quite cool. Anyway, then we'll leave Mr. Minotaur alone. There seems to be only one way down, my dear, so I hope your Pathfinder can deal with this. Just about, yeah. Alright, what have we got here? More trees growing underground. I'm not convinced of the scientific accuracy of this, but it sure as hell looks impressive at least. Oh, we got bears. I saw a wolf over there somewhere. Should we try and leave the bear alone as well? I horribly murdered some... Oh Christ, hello, there's another one. I horribly murdered a woman who probably didn't deserve it earlier. I'm feeling pretty bad about that on the whole. Oh dear. Serana, leave the bear alone, it's running away. Leave it alone. He was just running off to grab reinforcements. Oh, they're all beaten up on the Minotaur. Serana, you just shot the Minotaur. Don't. Just leave it out. Don't. Please. It's not worth it, love. It's just... No, it... Thank you. It's not worth it, love. It's not worth it. Right. What's that? Silver ore. Ooh. Would that be horribly insensitive of me to dig up a bunch of silver ore with you stood around here? I don't know. Vampires, silver, is that a thing? I know in real world folklore, vampires do not like silver, but I can't remember whether that's a thing in the Elder Scrolls. Because logically speaking, it probably wouldn't be, because the whole thing with vampires and silver in the real world, and, you know, using that term relatively loosely, because of course vampires do not bloody exist, and you are an idiot if you think they do. Sorry, but it's true. The idea is that, you know, the first vampire was Judas, I think, and he hates silver because of the 52 pieces of, or however many pieces of silver it was that Judas was given in order to betray Jesus and stuff like that, you know, and so on and so on and so on. That's why vampires don't like silver, but of course there is no Jesus in the Elder Scrolls, and so therefore it would stand to reason vampires don't have a problem with silver in this game. Anyway. I want to go listen to some Judas Priest now. Anyway. Alright, I guess that's all there is to it. It's there's not much here other than a just fantastic view of a wonder of the natural world, I guess. What are those up there? Is that leaves? Okay, no, yeah, it is leaves. It's like a fern growing on the top there. I thought it was like some sort of crystal. Alright, fair enough. We found a big old cave with a couple of... No. We must go deeper. Okay. Got a bit of caveception going on here now. Mr. Minotaur, I'm just... Again. Don't mind us.
Be careful.
Oh my word.
This won't end well for you.
Ancient glass golem. Wow. Hello. If I can remember my hotkeys, I might actually get a hammer out and start whacking you. There we go. And a cave bear. Of course. That's a huge cave. Wow, you have a lot of health, mate. Not enough, though, sadly. Is this? Oh, ooh, holy physics. Batman. That is not. Okay, right, well. Anything over here? What do we have? We have a dead orc. How did you end up here, I wonder? How have you... I mean, because you've not been eaten by the bear. That's all I'm thinking. Oh, God. There's more bears. I can hear them. I think there's probably another Minotaur having a go at a bear. Yeah. Whoa. Crikey. Hello. Right. He's going to shuffle now up here. There's really no way past this fella, is there? Listen, old mate, we just want to pass on through. We've come this far, really. Curiosity demands we go further. Look, I'm not... You're getting closer! Listen. I'm not... Uh-oh. Right. Okay. You know what? I have an idea. Crap. Is a Minotaur an animal? Will you know, Kine's piece work on him? Probably not.
Cut!
Bugger. No, didn't think so. Okay. Right. What about Ben Will? Except I can't shout now because... He's shuffling away, Serana. Leave him alone. Come on, he's had enough, clearly. Just Look. Really, it's. I think you're just being mean now. Look, he's not even trying to fight back. He's just. He's had. Will you. Will you stop it? Honestly. You bully. Go on. Like, No.
Oi. Like this.
Will you please. Put a. Fucking it. Oh, Christ. Hello. That didn't quite work, did it? Alright, maybe I need to charge it up a bit.
What have you got?
Did that do it? You alright now, mate? Okay, looks like he's pretty chill. Come on, Serrano, let's just go before it fucking wears off. Oh. So this is what we came here for. Another dead orc. A big pile of bones and stuff. Right, come on, come on. Probably should have killed him. He might have even had some nice loot on him, but still, it just felt mean. He wasn't even trying to fight back, Serrano. He was. Come on. Have you no pity? You bloodthirsty witch. Honestly. I think I'm overcompensating a little bit for having. You know. Socked Sapphire, a new one. Back there in the tavern, but at least by in doing that, I did the rest of the town a favor. I think killing these poor fellas living here by themselves, not minding their own business, isn't really helping anyone. Ugh. Hello, Lockpick, my old friend. I've come to talk to you again. Circlet of eminent increased speed. You move 12% faster. That's not bad, actually. Dragon scale armor. I can probably find a use for you. I will take you. No. It just continues, doesn't it? Curious place. Still with me, yep. Can I shove this off the end? No, okay. The childish vandal in me is unsatisfied. I cannot trash the mammoth skeleton. And God knows how the mammoth skeleton got up there in the first place. I suppose maybe one of the minotaurs are just sort of decorating. Told himself, mammoth skeleton, look good up there, me think. Right, how are we going to get past you? I can just bend will on you, I suppose. But I think we might be able to get around you here. Bit wet, but that's okay. Alright, well, it was very nice meeting you. We'll be on our way then, I suppose. You have a lovely home. As caves go, yeah, it's quite charming. It's. Uh-oh. Serrano, leave him alone. Leave it out. Yeah, we're going now, mate. Sorry, I do apologise on behalf of my friend here. She's just, you know. Oh, she's teleported again. Oh, Christ. Sorry, mate. We'll just leave you to your business. Sorry to disturb you. You take care now. Whew. What can I say, Serrano? I can't take you anywhere, can I?